Greetings of the day. From this video lecture, we are going to start our last and the fourth unit, that is cash flow for investment analysis. In this unit, we will first of all cover in this video lecture the theoretical portion related to the cash flow statement or cash flow analysis. Later on, we will see the the example of cash flows along with its pro forma or format. So, what is the meaning or concept of cash flow? Cash flow statement provides the information about cash receipts and cash payments of a firm during a particular given period. This statement deals with provision of information about what are the historical changes in cash equivalent of an enterprise by means of cash flow statement, which classifies cash flow during the period in three categories, that is operating cash flows, investing activities and financing activities. So, cash flow statement provides the detailed information about what are the cash receipts and cash payment of an enterprise for a particular given. Then, all other commercial, industrial or business support enterprises whose turnover for an accounting period is more than 50 crores, they are also required to follow the cash flow statement. Then, what can be the benefit or advantages of using cash flow statement? First one is it helps for internal financial management of the company. Company can easily find out and manage their internal finances. Second one is it helps to determine the likely cash flows of the company. It means that we can determine from where we have received how much amount, what are our cash inflows and where that amount is invested, that is what are our cash outflows. Then it helps in efficient cash management. We can definitely see that there would be a properly cash management because there would be tracking of all the cash expenditures of the company, whether they are irrespective of any activity, whether they are of nature of operating, financial or investment. Then it helps to disclose the movement of the cash. Definitely by cash flow statement we can easily find out the movement of the cash, whether from where we are generating the revenues and from where the revenues are going. That all can be seen by the way of cash flow statement. That is what is the another benefit of the cash flow statement. Then it helps to determine success and failure of cash planning. It is quite necessary to have the cash planning in the company so that company would maintain the liquidity at every point of time. And this can be done by properly preparing the cash flow statement because it tells us whether we are able to achieve properly with regard to our cash planning or not. It helps us to find out from where we got failed in our cash planning. Then it is also a supplement to fund flow statement. Usually fund flow statement, if you remember, you have drawn fund flow statement in which one part is for sources of fund and second one was for uses of fund. Similar here, there we have taken fund, but from cash flow statement is the primary stage by which we can, even though here it would help us to prepare the fund flow statement, here we only took the cash related expenses or income of the company. Then it acts as a better tool for the analysis by the management so that they could track the cash related all the activities of the company. Next is the importance of cash flow statement. The very first thing is preventing and monitoring company debt. It helps in monitoring the properly company debt because there should be proper planning with regard to the repayment or redemption of the debt, and for that purpose cash flow analysis is quite necessary by the company. Next, preventing unnecessary expenditure from interest, late payment penalties and debt cost. By maintaining the cash flow statement, we can definitely go for proper cash outflow planning with regard to interest and debt related all the things, which would help us to save ourselves from the late payment or penalties or charges or any kind of things. Then ensuring timely investment and cash available for investment opportunity. Whenever there is an investment opportunity, cash flow statement can definitely tell us our liquidity position and we can definitely go for that investment, grabbing that investment opportunity. Next is the ensuring timely payment of expenses and debts. By having cash flow statement, we can definitely plan our expenses accordingly, even though whenever we are going for raising a debt, there is definitely a deadline on which we have to redeem that debt. If suppose a company has raised a debt of rupees XYZ, which is to be repaid after 10 years, at the end of the 10 years, the company need to pay the whole principal amount. That is why at that particular point of time, it might be difficult for the company to raise that much amount of fund or to have the cash availability or liquidity for the purpose of repayment of the debt. At that point of time, what company can do, by a cash flow statement, they can definitely track the funds for which are going to be outflowed or inflowed and plan accordingly for those things in very timely and proper manner. Next is ensuring the level of regular business income without relying on outside investment or cash borrowing. By preparing cash flow analysis, we can definitely ensure the regular business income. Regular income. And they do not have to go for any kind of debt raising or cash borrowing from any other for the purpose of payment of any kind of expenditure which is been scheduled or unscheduled or emergency expenditure. Then now would be the last theoretical portion of the cash flow statement, that is limitation of cash flow statement or cash flow analysis. Very first thing is misleading inter-firm comparison. Usually the comparison, if any investor is going for the cash flow statement of the inter-firm comparison, there would be misleading results can be seen because there may be difference in the sales and purchases of the both the firms. Similarly, the cash policy and the debtors and creditors policy also has an impact on the cash flow statement. Hence, the result if we are seeing from the cash flow statement can turn to the misleading for the investors. Second thing, misleading comparison over a period of time. Definitely, if we are making comparison of YOY, that is year comparison of the cash flow statement of one company, there can be a misleading comparison for the same tenure also, because it might be possible that the situation of first year to another year can be different. There might be difficulty, or we cannot compare the situation of 2019 to 2021 because there was a sudden change due to the pandemic. Hence, all these kind of things has an impact on the which is not equated into the cash flow statement. Therefore, the result can be misleading over a period of time. Then, misleading inter-industry comparison. If suppose an investor or borrower or a creditor is making and comparison by way of cash flow statement between inter-industry, again there might be chances that it could lead to mislead them, because again the policies could be different, the purchases and sales are different. Over a period of time, it might be possible that one company would have greater cash flow, greater cash requirement due to the huge capital outlay in the near future. That is why they are having a different cash flow statement, representation, and while other is not having any kind of huge cash outflow. Therefore, this could mislead as we are making the inter-industry comparison also. Then another thing is that cash flow statement is not a replacement to other statement. If a company is preparing cash flow statement, whether it is mandatory or not, it acts as a supplement to them. It is not the thing that if we are preparing the cash flow statement, we are not required to prepare the final accounts or any other necessary statement which are been required by us. It is just a supplement. That is what is the another limitation of cash flow analysis. Next is, it is influenced by the changes in the management policy. Usually it is seen into the past that the cash flow statement doesn't reveal the actual liquidity position of the businesses. The cash flow positions are influenced by the management of the company and purchase and sales policies, which we have discussed into the first point. Hence, if there is a policy adopted by the company with regard to making and purchases at the great rate, that they would make an advance payment again, it would have an impact on the what we can say cash flow analysis. Hence, it cannot be we cannot take into the only consideration as a qualitative parameter. Next is the it cannot be equated with the income statement. Definitely, in cash flow analysis, we only take one thing into parameter, that is cash related transactions. Whereas in income statement, both cash and non-cash items are taken into consideration, which is the major, this is the major drawback of the cash flow analysis. Hence, it cannot be equated with the income statement, and that is why these limitations are being posed. That is why it has been quite discouraged by the companies for preparing of cash flow analysis, apart from those companies which are been mandatory required to go for the cash flow analysis as per the accounting standard, that is AS3. This is it for the theoretical portion of cash flow analysis. In the next lecture, we will see the pro forma of cash flow statement. Until then, stay tuned. Thank you.